Hi everyone, my name is Fox.
And I'm Fede. Today we'll learn how to install Drupal.
Last time we saw what is Drupal.
Now that we covered the basic concepts, we can finally install it.
Today we'll cover the basic installation without too many details, but with all the fundamental steps. For this purpose, we'll use the Acquia Drupal distribution. Let us all remember that this podcast is for non-experts, those who get in touch with Drupal for the first time.
In future episodes, we'll see how to install Drupal manually from scratch. And also we'll talk about some more difficult concepts like database, web servers, FTPs, but for now, let's keep it simple.
First, let's go to acquia.com/downloads. And choose the appropriate download for our operating system. Let's download and save the package to our hard drive. The Acquia package contains all the files and programs necessary to run the web platform on our computer. Let's open and install the package following the instructions from the basic installation. You will have to insert your password in order to get administrative permissions. On the install location screen, let's keep the default parameters, but pay attention to the installation path. In this case, users Federico Pistono cites Acquia Drupal. This is where the source code for our website will be. Let's keep it in mind for later. We will see later on the meaning of listening ports, web server, and database. But for now, let's carry on without touching anything. Let's give our website a name, fill in the last forms, and check the data we have so far. Perfect! We are ready to proceed with the installation.
Now that we have completed the installation, we can already take a look at our website. Acquia Drupal is a very special version of Drupal, easy to install and configure, and it integrates a bunch of modules that are essential for using a complete web platform. The website is ready. We can log in using the username and password we chose during the installation. Perfect! We are now in as administrators. Let's see the basic structure and configuration. The administration panel is split into working categories or by module. In content management, it's possible to create and manage the website's content, static pages, blog posts, articles, and much more. User management allows us to give special permissions for viewing, creating, and deleting content to a particular group of users. Reports will give us a status update on the health of our website by using very detailed logs. Site building is used to manage blogs, change the menus, install and uninstall modules, and change the graphic theme. Site configuration gathers all the general configuration.
This looks so empty. I mean, what do you say, Fox? Can we make a little spoiler and create the first content?
Alright, but don't give too much out. Okay. We have a lot to cover and we shall proceed step by step. After all, this is a podcast for beginners. Mm-hmm. Also, I'm better at speaking English than I'm using Drupal, so figure that out.
Okay, let's check it out.
Okay, create content, page, and we are ready to generate our first page. Let's give her a title. Make it visible from the main menu. And we also want it to appear on the front page. Et voilà! We have successfully installed Drupal on our local computer. And we also created the first content.
This installation happened in our local machine, which means that the rest of the world cannot see it yet. First, we will learn how to configure Drupal, use the core modules and the most downloaded contributed modules. Then we will see how to make it visible online.
Stay tuned.